SVR IAS Online Academy welcomes you to the Environment and Ecology video lectures. Our website is comeonindia.com. In this video lecture, you will learn about Bonn Convention and its importance in environment and ecology, how to approach this topic for prelims examination, what are the important points you should remember for prelims examination, what is Bonn, is a place where it is located. Bonn Convention aims to conserve which species? It is a migratory species that already you know. And migratory species means whether it is a aviation or terrestrial migratory animals, terrestrial or marine. Whether Bonn Convention aims to protect aviation or terrestrial animals or marine animals or all of the three, you should know that. Then what is the importance of Convention on Migratory Species? How it is important? What are the important features you should write in the mains examination if a question asked in the Bonn Convention? And appendix of the Bonn Convention is also important appendix. There are two appendix, appendix 1, appendix 2. So let's discuss the convention in detail. The first important exam point in the Bonn Convention is that Bonn is a place in Germany. In Germany. Second important point is that Bonn Convention is on the conservation of migratory species. Migratory species. It aims to conserve the migratory species throughout their range. Before going into the details about the Bonn Convention, let's understand some basics about migratory species. First of all, what are migratory species? Migratory species, which means the species or animals migrate from one place to the another place. Beyond this range, it will not go out because some animals may need temperate climate. The animal will not go to polar region, or you can say the tropical region, because it cannot survive there. Like that, every animal has its own range. It can't go beyond that. Like that, not only terrestrial animals, as you know, it may be aviation. Birds, you know, migrating from one place to another place. Some birds starts migration in polar region and reaches Africa for breeding and one place for feeding. Birds have the longest migratory range. Apart from terrestrial, aquatic, apart from this aviation and terrestrial, there is aquatic animals, they also migrate. For example, whales migrate from one ocean to another ocean, from Pacific Ocean to Indian Ocean and goes back. So these are about the migratory species. So there are three types of migratory species or animals. One is terrestrial and second is aviation or birds. Third is aquatic animals. Then let's understand the concept of range states. Range states means migratory species or animal may move not only within that country, may cross the border from one country and enter another country. So if a animal or migratory species has their habitat in more than one country, these countries called as range states. For example, take the example of Himalayas. Himalayas located, the range is located in the north, goes to China, here in south India, in the middle Nepal, Bhutan, in the west the range goes to Afghanistan, in the west goes to Pakistan. So if a migratory species located in one part of the Himalaya may move through the Himalayan range, So it covers more than one country. These countries are called as range countries for particular migratory species. As you know, Bonn Convention on Conservation of Migratory Species came into force in 1979. It is another important prelims point. It came in 1979. India became a signatory to the convention since 1983. The another important point is that already we discussed Bonn is a place in Germany. Bonn Convention is the environmental treaty which is under the aegis of United Nations Environmental Programme. It is another important prelims point. Don't forget, it is under United Nations Environment Programme. The another important point is that Bonn Convention is the only global convention specialized in the conservation of migratory species. There is no other convention is available for conserving the migratory species. Let's discuss the appendices of the Bonn Convention. In Appendix 1, the migratory species are included which are threatened with extinction. The migratory species which are threatened with extinction are included in the Appendix 1. Appendix 1 provides greatest level of protection or conservation effort. Greatest level of conservation. Thus, Appendix 2 is that the migratory species are not threatened with extinction, but they need cooperation so that their survival can be ensured. These kind of migratory species are included in the Appendix 2. Let's discuss about the structure of Bonn Convention. Bonn Convention has many bodies. The important one is Conference of Parties. Conference of Parties, which is the highest decision-making authority. The other committees are Standing Committee, Scientific Council, and a Secretariat, which is provided by the United Nations Environment Programme. Why there is a separate convention at the global level is required to protect the marine or migratory species. As already we discussed, migratory species move from one habitat to other habitat across the countries, so they are transnational in nature. For that, international level convention is required, which provides uniform conservatory measures or standards. So that Bonn Convention was created in 1979. Because feeding places and breeding areas becomes threatened and habitat loss also occurs, which threatens the survival of migratory species. So Bonn Convention aims to ensure that feeding and breeding areas and habitat are safeguarded and survival of the migratory species are ensured. That's all about the Bonn Convention on Migratory Species. The important prelims point in this topic are, it is under the United Nations Environment Programme, started in 1979. India is a signatory to the Bonn Convention. India signed this in 1983, and there are two appendix are there. Appendix 1, the species are included which are faces extinction, which provides greatest level of protection. Appendix 2 is that migratory species are included which is not threatened with extinction, which needs international level conservation efforts. Download the PDF for revision purpose. All the best for your IAS 2016 exam preparation.